Toyota Research Institute just demoed its newest Punyo AI robot using breakthrough large behavioral models to teach humanoids dexterous skills quickly and efficiently. But there's a twist, because this new method uses a generative AI diffusion policy to transform the way robots interact with their environments, both at home and at work. So what's all the excitement around large behavior models for machines? To start, TRI's robot training is built on the foundation diffusion policy, which finally allows any robot to learn new skills with remarkable speed and with fewer demonstrations than ever before. The significance here is comparable to the impact that large language models have had on chatbots like ChatGPT, but now applied to physical behaviors instead. And TRI is rapidly growing these large behavior models to enable robots to perform complex tasks in ways that were previously unimaginable. To put this into perspective, most robotic manipulation to date has focused on basic tasks like picking and placing objects, but TRI's new method extends far beyond these limitations. For instance, robots trained through TRI's diffusion policy can now use tools and even their whole bodies to accomplish their goals. Because of this, robots can engage with their surroundings in rich, multifaceted ways without requiring any explicit programming to acquire new skills. To make it universally applicable, this process begins with a human teacher demonstrating a small set of skills via teleoperation. Then, the AI takes over with its diffusion policy, learning the demonstrated behaviors in just a few hours. Typically, a robot can be taught a new skill in the afternoon, learn overnight, and be ready to perform the task the next morning. Another even more crucial element in this process, though, is the sense of touch. For this, the humans use haptic teleoperation devices to provide tactile feedback, which significantly enhances the robot's learning capabilities. For instance, when teaching a robot to flip a pancake, the sense of touch is crucial for the robot to make contact with the surface it cannot see. This tactile feedback helps the robot learn the skill much more quickly. And in addition to having such fine motor skills, TRI is also making strides in larger-scale robotic manipulation with their new robot named Punyo, which is derived from the Japanese word for soft, cute, and resilient. Physically speaking, though, what sets Punyo apart from other robots are its arms, hands, and chest, which are covered with tactile sensors and compliant materials, allowing for safe and effective manipulation of large, heavy, and unwieldy objects. Furthermore, unlike traditional robot grippers, Punyo's arms end in soft, bubble-like paws equipped with high-resolution tactile sensing cameras. These features enable Punyo to grasp objects securely and distribute forces evenly, preventing slippage. Importantly, Punyo's design focuses on using its whole body, arms, chest, and tactile feedback to perform robust manipulation tasks. And Punyo's functional design focuses on a new manipulation paradigm where the robot can use its whole body from its arms to its chest to collect tactile feedback data. Moreover, Punyo learns from not only direct human demonstrations, but also high-fidelity simulations. And during these demonstrations, camera feeds, tactile sensor data, and robot motions are all recorded to help the robot to replicate the same tasks autonomously. Plus, Punyo can learn new skills in simulation too, simply by being given a starting point, goal, and a single rough demonstration. This is a breakthrough that allows Punyo to determine the necessary motions to rotate and lift various large objects efficiently, all by itself. And by integrating grippy skin and manipulating objects close to its chest, Punyo can more easily handle significantly heavier objects, all while using less power, making it even more energy efficient to work for long periods. Finally, the robot's whole body approach provides enhanced safety, reactivity, and approachability, making Punyo an increasingly approachable cobot to automate repetitive human tasks. Most importantly, though, the team plans to continue building large behavior models so that robots can generalize and learn new tasks themselves. In fact, by the end of this year, TRI plans to add hundreds of new behaviors to their fleet of robots, with a target of over 1,000 new behaviors by the end of 2024, and all of their robots are also said to learn in simulation to better enable fleet-wide learning in real-world scenarios, ensuring that when one robot learns, all robots in the cloud will also benefit. And meanwhile, a startup launched last year named MagicLab has been revolutionizing humanoid robots by focusing on electrically powered designs. the company has developed advanced motor joints and actuators, enabling their robots to exhibit remarkable agility and balance. And one standout feature is the robot's ability to perform somersaults, proving that electric robots can achieve dynamic movements without expensive hydraulic systems. In fact, MagicLab's joint motor design allows their robots to maintain stability during complex aerial maneuvers, proving that electric power doesn't compromise performance. This breakthrough is significant because electrically powered robots are generally less expensive to build and maintain. By reducing costs without sacrificing dexterity or mobility, MagicLab's robots become viable for broader applications. And future developments aim to enhance the robot's capabilities with advanced acrobatic moves like single-leg jumps and backflips. Beyond acrobatics, though, MagicLab also showcased a barista robot making coffee to highlight the technology's versatility. This suggests potential uses in hospitality, healthcare, and other sectors requiring precision and adaptability. And as MagicLab continues to innovate, their cost-effective, highly capable robots may begin work trials across various industries. And finally, Aloha researchers have just unveiled their updated robots with unprecedented generalizability and dexterity in a groundbreaking demonstration at Stanford University and Google DeepMind. But will this new tech pave the way for the first self-sustaining robotic systems to finally take shape? Impressively, the Aloha Unleashed project is pushing the limits of robot dexterity and task complexity with their brand new fleet of advanced Aloha 2 manipulator arms. In fact, these new robot arms not only surpass their predecessors in terms of durability, but also performance, and they've been meticulously upgraded to enable fleet-scale data collection on more complex tasks. But the Aloha 2 arms come with several other key enhancements too. To start, traditional scissor grippers have been replaced with low-friction rails, significantly improving grasping capabilities. The integration of smaller RealSense cameras with a broader field of view allows for better visual processing. A passive gravity compensation setup and an overhead vision camera further enhance these robots' functionality. Additionally, the team has developed a new simulation model with improved accuracy and visuals, boosting the learning capabilities of these remarkable machines. And the Aloha Unleashed project doesn't stop at simple demonstrations, because the researchers have already tackled some of the most dexterous tasks imaginable, including tying shoelaces, hanging shirts, and replacing robot fingers. And the implications of this breakthrough are far-reaching, because these kinds of autonomous robotic maintenance and repair capabilities could quickly revolutionize industries ranging from manufacturing to exploration, with the ability to self-sustain and self-repair robotic systems, potentially unlocking brand new frontiers of efficiency, safety, and cost-effectiveness.